Between Apple launches, Google announcements, and Hurricane Sandy, we got ourselves a perfect technology storm. I'm Bridget Carey, and this is your CNET Update. The initial supply of iPad minis available for pre-order sold out on Apple.com in less than a half hour. And Friday morning, the shipments for the Wi-Fi only version were pushed back for 2 weeks. Shocking, I know. Some of the first people that ordered a mini with a 4G wireless connection won't be getting it until Black Friday. That's November 23rd. Meanwhile, Apple's fourth generation full-sized iPad, which has a faster processor, didn't suffer from the Friday rush. If you want to buy a 4G iPad mini from a wireless carrier, you should be able to do that in the coming days, since that model doesn't hit stores until November 16th. The Windows 8 era has arrived. The system is available at stores now, and Windows users can download the $40 upgrade to Windows 8 Pro. Will you be upgrading or buying a new computer? Did you already make the leap? Send a video reply using the Tout app, or you can email update@cnet.com to share your thoughts about the new system and your upgrade experiences. And those of you with a PC or tablet running Windows RT or Windows 8 can now use Smart Glass with your Xbox. The Smart Glass app puts additional info on the tablet screen about what you're watching, and it can also be used as a way to control and navigate games, shows, movies, and music. It's coming soon for Apple, Android, and Windows Phone 8. Looks like Google isn't caring too much about keeping the Nexus 10 tablet a secret. Google's senior vice president of engineering uploaded photos taken by a Nexus 10 tablet, or at least that's what it says when you click on the image details. There were also images of a tablet leaked on the site Brief Mobile. This Nexus 10 tablet made by Samsung is said to have a better display than the iPad, but we'll find out for certain soon when Google unveils it at a Monday event. And a message from my East Coast techies that are in the path of the Frankenstorm, Hurricane Sandy. You don't want to be caught unprepared if there's a long-term power outage. Now's the time to see what kind of backup cell phone recharger you can get at the store. You can find some solar chargers, like this case by Mobius, but solar tends to take a while to charge. Some iPhone cases have a built-in backup battery, or you can buy an external battery backup pack like this one by Monoprice, and it has a USB port for multiple devices. Make sure you have a car charger handy, since that might be the only way to recharge until your home power is restored. And if there's an emergency and you're having trouble getting a call to connect, send a text message. Text messages go through. Even if it's busy and there's a delay, that text will just wait in the queue until things free up. And it also uses less resources on the network. Don't count on your cell phone to be reliable. A transistor radio and a pack of batteries can be your best friend. That's your tech news update for today. From the CNET studios in New York, I'm Bridget Carey.